I'm Mike from Meeps Coffee Roasters, and today we've got a new grinder for our espresso bar, the Mythos Two. I'm going to carry out an unboxing, cover the spec sheet, features, and have a discussion of why we chose this machine. Then we're going to use this grinder in our espresso bar for a few months, and then carry out another review. Let's check it out. So here it is, the Gravimetric Mythos 2. We're no stranger to this grinder. When it first came out, which was about a year ago in New Zealand, we borrowed one for half a day and used it in our espresso bar. We've also sold a few of these grinders to the cafes that we supply to, which involved training, calibration, and cleaning and maintenance on these grinders. We're upgrading this grinder from a Mazza electronic grinder, which we're currently dosing by volume, and we've got a separate set of weighing scales in which we're weighing each shot. With this grinder, it's going to obviously change all that. Some of the main features why we chose the Mythos 2 are gravimetric. The Mythos 2 has the ability to grind by weight, meaning that its built-in weighing scales give you a precise amount of ground coffee delivered into the portafilter basket. Also, it's burrs. The Mythos 2 has flat, large 85mm grinding burrs. Thermal regulation for temperature control. The Mythos 1 was a great grinder, but it did have many issues in a high volume environment where the grinder would reach a certain temperature and it would not operate as consistent as it should. A lot of these problems are supposed to be fixed in the new model of the Mythos 2 with the new thermal regulation system that keeps the temperature at a consistent level, helping to achieve consistency. Also, its low volume motor offers a much quieter operation. We've all used those old clunky doser grinders that make an extremely loud whirl and grinding noise in the cafe. And also, its precision and accuracy is renowned to be remarkable. We're really looking forward to testing this out. So the Mythos 2 is not the only grind by weight gravimetric grinder on the market today. There are many others, and there are other grinders with very similar features. When choosing what grinder to use for an espresso bar, we weighed up some advantages and some disadvantages of this model compared to those other models. So some of the disadvantages. The Mythos 2 is renowned to be relatively slow. It takes time for the built-in scales to tear to zero when entering the portafilter. The grind speed. Although this is adjustable, the grind speed can be a little bit slow. The lower the RPM, the slower the grind speed. The higher the RPM, the higher the grind speed. Cleaning and maintenance. The Mythos 2 is easier to clean and more accessible than the Mythos 1, but it does require you to replace these plastic inserts called clump crushers, which do cost a little bit of time and money. However, this is an advantage because these clump crushers reduce clumping, which also reduces channeling within your espresso. And some advantages according to the spec sheet. The Mythos 2 has a new technology of a thermal regulation system which helps stabilize the temperature of the grinder. This ultimately creates a much more consistent and even grind without burning the beans under any volume or any environment. The burrs. The Mythos 2 has large 85mm burrs, which are bigger than many of its other competitors. The burrs are also titanium, whereas a lot of the other grinders have steel burrs. Another note is that the Mythos 2 does not fit a Lamazoco portafilter from standard, so we have to buy these forks in order to fit our Lamazoco machine. One other disadvantage. The Mythos 2 is f***ing expensive. It is almost the price of an entry-level espresso machine, and it hurts the wallet. Is it worth it? Well, we're going to use this grinder for a few months in our espresso bar and do another video weighing up the pros and cons of the grinder. I'm also going to do a few videos calibrating the grinder and some tutorials on how to program it. So let us know if you're looking at buying one or if you own a Mythos 2, and I'll keep an eye out and I'll see you soon. Boop, boop.